ശ്രീ ഇടി മുഹമ്മദ് ബഷീർ.
Thank you very much, sir. So to be frank, acute anarchy is continuing in Kashmir Valley. So even this morning newspapers tell you the story of blood and tears from Kashmir. We can very well imagine the deplorable situation in a place where curfew is continuing for the last 12 days continuously. Food supply and drinking water is also affected. Schools are remain closed and death roll reached to 50. And telephone connectivity is completely suspended. So in spite of all these things, it is strange to note that some people are advocating for this Kashmir government led by BJP and PDP. Sir, I would like to say with all the politeness that this government in Kashmir is the most inefficient government the Kashmir has ever seen. Sir, it's a government good for nothing. In spite of all these things, they have miserably failed in controlling the situation. I fail to understand on what basis some people are justifying this government. Sir, with regard to the press, we are all proud of our democracy. Ours is the biggest democracy in the world. So what happened there? Chief Minister still says that everything is, there is no curb on the press. Sir, Editors Guild of India today categorically stated that it is undemocratic, coercive steps against the press. Press was raided and compelled to close down. Sir, we have to realize muscling of the print and electronic media that is happening there. Sir, I would like to say that it is a shame for the nation. This kind of attitude is led by this government in Kashmir. Sir, as far as the security forces are concerned, we must have a loud thinking about their activities. Sir, they are treating the civilians as enemies, as terrorists. It's a very serious thing. Security forces, they are having arms. We can very well understand. But Kashmir security forces, they are having a sharp, edged, unseen arm with them. What is that? That is AFSPA, that Armed Forces Special Power Act. Using that, they are doing all cruelty against the civilians there. Sir, stone pelting from one side, gun firing from the other side, civilians are in between that. Sir, government is really in the role of a siren spectator. Our Prime Minister go around the world and talk about the world peace. But what is happening in our own country, we must have a loud thinking about that also. Sir, people were saying about, my learned friends were saying about terrorism and the role of Pakistan in this. Yes, terrorism is there. It is engineered by Pakistan. That also is a fact. This country should unitedly support the government to fight the terrorism. All are with the government in fighting terrorism to the nail. We have to fight it. We all support the government in that fight. See, we have to understand one more thing. Is it the only reason? That is the point to be discussed. Is it the only reason for the turbulence in Kashmir? That also we have to think. Sir, what is happening in the development side? My learned friends were saying they are totally dissatisfied, discontent, disillusioned. Sir, if we verify, if we examine the development indicator, we will be convinced Kashmir is in the lowest bottom level. Development indicators shows that Kashmir is neglected like anything. We have to realize a fact. Kashmir is an integrated part of India. Sir, when we are distributing the national wealth, we should do it in a judicious manner. I would like to say, whether it is Kashmir, northeastern state, south, everywhere, judicious kind of consideration should be there. Okay. Sir, I would like to say, ad hocism cannot work. Towards the end, kindly permit me to say one more thing. These kind of cruel laws, I told you, special powers for the armed forces. This kind of back law should be scrapped. This house has demanded that several times. Sir, we are having bitter experience with various such legislations, such as POTA, TADA, UAPA, and all kind of things. These kind of back law will never make good result. At the same time, it will only add fuel in the fire. So I once again demand that such law should be scrapped at once. With these few words, I once again condemn activities taking place in Kashmir now. Sir, I conclude. Thank you. Thank you very much. Sir,